Hello you guys, welcome and welcome back to another video. Today in this video I'm going to show you how to design this crossover flyer with Photoshop. So without any further ado, let's jump right in. So a subscriber asked this question: why do you use 300 ppi resolution for your design in Photoshop? This is a very cool question and I'm going to answer that. So you see, 300 ppi is actually the best resolution for print designs, and if you are designing for digital purpose, maybe a design that will end on your screen or on your phone, then you can use 150 PPI. So PPI means pixel per inch and DPI means dot per inch, and these are actually small dots that forms the image you see in Photoshop. That is why Photoshop works with pixels. So those little pixels you see, like tiny squares, forms the image you see in Photoshop, and that is why you have to use 300 PPI for best resolution print when it comes to design with Photoshop. A lot of people make this mistake by using anything less than 300 to design for a print, and when the print comes out, it comes out very blur and pixelated. So don't do this mistake. So for me, I prefer using 300 ppi all the way for all my designs, whether for print or for digital purpose. So if you'd like me to answer your Photoshop questions just like this one in my next video, comment your questions down below. So let's begin. Welcome to Photoshop. So what we are going to do here is to create a new document. So I will click on create new, and it opens up this dialog box. I have to choose the presets I want to work with. Okay, that's cool and nice. So I'm going to click on A5, and once I click on A5, that's a recent preset I've used, just like what you can see here. But if you don't want to use your recent preset just like this, you go to print and then you go to A5 and make sure you set your preset details just here. You can give your file name here, you can set your unit. I prefer working with pixels, so I'll leave it at pixels, and I'll leave my orientation to portrait because the flyer I want to design is a portrait flyer. So you leave your orientation here at portrait. Okay, if you need landscape, this is landscape, and your resolution here again, 300 pixels per inch. That's cool. And your color mode, RGB. Okay, I know this is for print, but I'm going to use RGB, and when I want to print, I can convert it to CMYK. I prefer designing with RGB. Fine. So next thing you want to do is to leave every other details just the way it is at default, and you are good to go. You click on create. So once you click on create, this opens up just like what you see here, and then I have some resources I'll be using for this design, and these are all the resources I'll be using for this tutorial. So you can become a channel member to get access to resources I use for my designs just like this one. To become a channel member, click on join below this video, or you click on the link in the video description and become a channel member. So the first thing I'm going to do for this design is to treat my background. So I start with my background treatment to see how the background of the flyer will look like. So let's do this. If you are familiar with Windows 11, you know that you can't drag files directly to any software you want to use on the taskbar unless you do just what I just did now. So I'm going to click on this image and take it to Photoshop and place it just right there. You can maximize your Photoshop once you're okay with that. So I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to transform this background just like this. You can enlarge it just the way you want and keep it just at this scale, and that looks perfect. Then I'm going to take this upwards. Hold shift on your keyboard so you can remain on a straight line and take this upwards just like this. And real quick, I'm working with Photoshop CC 2021. So if you're using any other version less than Photoshop CC 2021, you've got no problem because we are still on the same page. All you're going to do is understand my moves and apply them to the version of Photoshop you use. Or if there be anything confusing, all you have to do is to go to Windows, you go to Workspace, and you go to Reset Essentials, and you're going to be on the same page with me. So let's get back to the design. So once you're done transforming this, you can just place it around here, and I think this looks very perfect. And then you're going to give your background a dark color. So I'm going to click on my background. You can unlock your background or leave it locked, it has no problem. So I'm going to click on my paint bucket tool and make sure your foreground is set to black just like this, and you click on the background layer and it gets this black color just like this. Then you click on the layer that has the road background. Then once you do that, you click on your layer mask to add a layer mask, just a white layer mask just like this. And once you do that, make sure your foreground is set to black. So you click on this icon to set your foreground to black just like what you see, and you press B on your keyboard to activate your brush, and this is just what we get as your brush. You can use the right square bracket to adjust your brush size, and then you paint on this other side of the road just to eliminate the sharp edge, not too much, but just to eliminate the sharp edge of this road, just like this. And I think this looks perfect and very nice. So once this is done, we're going to eliminate this dark part of the background because it looks so dark and it's not blending with the road background. So all we are going to do is to select the layer that has the road and press Ctrl T on your keyboard to transform, and hold Shift to adjust this just like this. So I'm adjusting it just to make the background so oblong like this. I think this look perfect and very nice. So you can do the same here, just to adjust this background like this and make it kind of oblong. It looks perfect this way. So we have been able to eliminate the darker part of the background, just like what you see here. And at the same time, you can take it upwards a little and place it just around here. So it's not too bad. It looks very cool. You can adjust this way as well and make sure it's at the center, just like what you see, and it looks very perfect. Take note of this, I'm actually placing the background in a way that fits my design, so everything looks very cool and nice at my own space. So once you're happy with that, you can hit enter on your keyboard to place the background just like what you see here. And I'm going to bring in the next resources we have for this. So I'm going to minimize my screen and bring in the sky background to my Photoshop and maximize the screen again, and then take this upwards to the top of the background. And then you place it just around here. It looks very perfect and very nice. Hit enter once you're okay with that to place the sky background just like what you see. So next thing we're going to do is to send this sky background to the back. So you press Ctrl left square bracket to send it to the back, and it's gone, but not forever. So the next thing I'm going to do is to select the road background once again on the layer, and I'm going to take off this part of the road background. So I'm going to rasterize this road so I'll be able to make some necessary edits. I'm going to right click on the layer and click on rasterize layer, and once you do this, you'll be able to edit it with your lasso tool. So you click on your polygonal lasso tool. So with your polygonal lasso tool, you're going to take off this part of the road background just like what you see here. You don't have to be perfect doing this, but just take off the road just like this, and it's okay. Once you do that, you just hit on delete to take off the background because I don't need it anymore. I want to replace this with the sky background. So you press Ctrl D to deselect, and then you get something like this. So you select the road background, and remember, we added a layer mask. What does the layer mask does? Black height and white reveal. So you click on the layer mask and then you click on your brush. Follow my steps and you won't have any problem. If you have mistakes following these steps, watch the video again and again and again, and you get this right, okay? Just follow my steps. So use your left square bracket to reduce your brush size, and you're going to hide parts of this road background just like this. Just hide the sharper parts of the road background, not too much, but just to take the sharper edges away, just like what you can see here. And I guess this looks very cool and nice. So it looks as if the road is taking you direct into the sky, okay? In 2022, the sky will not be your limit. You fly above the sky. Look, you have to take this in good faith. Say amen on the comments. So once you are at this point, then you are actually heading to greatness. Next thing we are going to do is to bring in the text effect I have for this flyer. So I'm going to open up my folder where I have the resources once again and double click on this full text effect. So in our previous video on the channel, I made a video on how to get 3D text effect. So now we're going to apply the 3D text effect here in our design. So this is the editable text effect, and it's actually 3D. So I'm going to hide the dodo layer. Just hide the layer, it's not necessary. And then you're going to delete the layer if possible. Delete the text layer, it's not necessary at this point in time. So I'm going to open up the text effect group. So once you do that, you have where you have replace text here. You double click on the thumbnail to open up this, and once you do that, you'll be able to add your own text here. So I'm going to copy the center of focus on where I have the writer for this flyer, crossover and takeover. You can copy that and bring it to Photoshop, and all you have to do is to paste it just here. Click on the full text and press Ctrl A on your keyboard and press Ctrl V to paste that. And this looks very cool and very nice. Actually, the size is too much, so I'm going to select or press Ctrl A and highlight all, and you can reduce the size to somewhere 50 points. Let's see how it looks. Okay, perfect. You can reduce the size again to 20 points. So we have everything just right inside here. Then you're going to cut this out, break the text just like this. Now the leading is too much, that's why everything looks clustered. So I'm going to select all and click on your character option, so you'll be able to edit your character, adjust your leading to automatic, and once you do that, everything goes back to normal, just like what you can see here. And you can adjust your typeface to champion, so I'll be using champion for this. And once you type champion, you see a variety of champion. I like to use the champion gothic middleweight. This looks very cool and perfect for this flyer. So with this, I'm going to click on paragraph and then centralize my type, and it looks as if the type is so close to each other, so I'm going to bring this to the middle. So once you are done with that, we're going to adjust the leading once again, because it looks as if they are so close to each other. So you activate your text tool and press Ctrl A, and once you do that, go back to character. Then you can set your leading to 19 points, and I think that looks very perfect and nice. You can close this panel because we don't want to edit that again. All you have to do is to press Ctrl T on your keyboard and adjust this, scale it up like this, and fill the whole canvas just like what you're seeing here. Fill the canvas just like this and hit on enter on your keyboard once you're okay with that, and press Ctrl S to save that. And once you save that, you can close this particular edit and it opens up in the main text effect just like this. So you have the 3D text effect ready. All you have to do next is to take off the background. So I'm going to hide the background layer, and you can possibly delete it because we don't need the background anymore. You will want to work with only the text effect. So you right click on the text effect layer and merge group. All we are trying to do is to reduce the file size, so when we take it to our design, it looks small with a small file size. You don't want this to be too large, else Photoshop starts lagging. So you click and drag on the crossover and takeover, take it to where we have our design and place it just around here. You see how it looks very cool and nice. Then you can close your full text effect and take notes, don't save this. Click on no, because we don't want this anymore. So with this, you can click and adjust the text effect to whatever you want and place it just around here, just like this. I guess this looks very cool and very nice at this position. So I'm going to leave it around here. And then you see the sky here does not match with what's happening on the design. So we're going to click on the sky again and adjust the color. We are actually doing color grading to blend with the design. So I'm going to press Ctrl B and then you open up the color balance panel just like this. Adjust yellows to 100%. That's minus 100% yellow. And adjust the reds to the extreme just like this. And then you can toggle with this green. So when you take this to the green part, you have something around this. So you have something around this. So you leave it around minus 30, just like what you see in here. So the background looks as if it blends with the crossover and takeover a little. You just hit on OK. And that looks very perfect. So we are going to adjust this sky background. You click on the sky background just like what you see here. Click on your adjustment layer and click on your curves. And it opens up this curves adjustment layer just like this. It may not open in this aspect in your own Photoshop, so you can use it just the way you like. And then you adjust this like this. Take this up a little, bring this down a little, just to get something close to this. Okay, I think this looks cool and very nice. So we move on. So once you're okay with that, you can hold on Alt on your keyboard, and with the curve adjustment layer selected, you click, you see this icon changes to this, so you click to link the curve adjustment layer to the sky. So you're telling Photoshop you want this curve adjustment to affect only the sky background alone. So I'm going to bring in every other stuff we need for this flyer just very fast. So I'll open up my folder once again and bring in the logo just right inside Photoshop. And then hit on enter and press Ctrl right square bracket to bring this to the top. Press Ctrl T to transform and reduce the size just like this and bring it to this position here. It looks very cool and very nice. Then I'm going to open up Microsoft Word and copy out these details and bring it to Photoshop. Just again, hit on T to activate your text tool and paste this just right here. We're going to adjust this text because it looks very bad on the eye. So we're going to press Ctrl A to highlight this text and align it to the left just like this, and once you do that, you're going to place it just around here. Press Ctrl T to transform, so you can reduce the size just like this and place it around here. Fine. Then we are going to highlight New Wave of Glory and bring it down to the end just like this, and change the font to Montserrat, just like what you see here. I make it Montserrat bold. I prefer this because it looks very cool. Then we're going to leave it just the way it is. And with this, we are going to select both layers where we have the church name and the logo. Select both of them and press Ctrl T to transform. So we're going to adjust this and place it at the center. Then you have that guideline that shows it's actually at the center of the design. Then you are good to go. Then I'm going to hit on enter to place this on the design. Press Ctrl G to group these two layers, and you can name this group church name just like this, so you don't get yourself confused when you are doing your design. So this is what we get. Next thing we are going to do is to bring in the next thing we have here, which is present. So you're going to copy present and bring it to Photoshop and paste it just right here. You can change the font to Montserrat Regular. So we have Montserrat Regular for this. Change the font size to 10 points. This looks very perfect. Then you can click on this adjustments. So you can adjust the tracking to somewhere around 500. I guess this looks perfect for this. So you place this present just at the center of the design, just like this. And it looks as if it's not so visible. So with this, I'm going to create a new layer just under present. So you click on church, which is a layer before present, and click on add layer, and it has this layer just like this. Activate your brush. Press B to activate your brush. Then you're going to set this brush to white, so you make your foreground to be white and reduce the brush size and just paint it around here just like this. You can click on filter and click on blur and Gaussian blur to make this look so blurry. You can leave your blur radius at 7.6. It looks perfect. So what I'm trying to do is to make the present look so visible, and the contrast will be perfect that way. So at this point, I'm going to copy out this A3D and bring it to Photoshop. You press T and paste just like what you see here. Then you're going to press Ctrl A to select all and change the font to Gotham. I'm going to leave the names of all the fonts I use for this flyer in the description so you can check it out. Then select that and make sure it's Gotham. You can change the tracking again to 0 because it actually takes the previous tracking which was made on the previous text. Then you're going to take this upwards just like what you see here. Take this to the top, press Ctrl T to transform and scale it up just like this. Place it around here at the center, and this looks perfect. And then you see it's actually very straight, so I'm going to make this to look curved. So you click on type and go to warp text, and it opens up this dialog box, so you can click on none and then click on arc. Then you have this curve like this. You adjust the blend to, I guess, plus 8 will be perfect. Okay, you click on OK to place that. Then you bring it just down here, very close to crossover. So we have a 3D crossover and take over. This looks perfect and nice. Then you click on your blending options and click on gradient overlay to open up your gradient dialog box. You click on the gradient editor, then you're going to adjust your gradient just like this. Make sure this other side is set to a kind of ash color gray, just like this. Looks perfect. Then you click on this other side of the slider and make sure it's white, so you have something just like this. You click on OK and you click on OK again. Then you can hold on your gradients to adjust the gradients just like this. See what I'm doing? It looks very cool and very nice. So you can adjust it this way and hit on OK. So this looks very perfect and nice. Press Ctrl J to duplicate this layer and bring it downwards just like this. Then you can highlight all and type here program. This looks perfect. So it takes the same edits we just made. Press Ctrl T to adjust this just like this and place it under here. This looks very perfect and nice. Then we're going to add shadows to this text, so you can click on your blending option again and hit on shadow, and then it opens up this dialog box just like this. You're going to adjust the opacity way down to 53. Looks perfect. Okay, let's leave it at 66, and then you adjust your spread, adjust your size. This looks perfect. You can hold on the drop shadow and place it just around here. It looks perfect. Adjust the opacity again to 79. Perfect and nice. Hit on OK. So you click on a 3D as well and click on your blending options. Click on drop shadow to activate the same shadow just like that. But you see, it's not taking the same shadow. So we are going to apply another step to do this. You click on cancel because we don't want to take that. We want to take the same shadow that is applied here. So you right click on this layer that has the program. Right click and click on copy layer style. Click on a 3D and then right click and paste layer style. So it copies the same layer style which we had there. Then you can press Ctrl left square bracket to send this to the back of crossover and take over. So I guess this looks perfect here. See, a 3D is at the back of crossover and takeover. So I'm arranging this to be in a kind of steps. Okay, it looks cool. So next thing I'm going to do is to click on U on my keyboard to activate the rectangle tool. You can click and hold on the rectangle tool. So you see other tools, you click on ellipse tool to activate the ellipse tool and hold shift on your keyboard and create this circle just like this. Then you have this circle just around here. You can place this circle very well around here. Press Ctrl T to transform and adjust this just like this. So when you get something like this, you're actually very good to go. So next thing you are going to do is to press Ctrl J on your keyboard to duplicate the ellipse layer where you have the ellipse tool. Now tell me this, many Photoshop users name their layers, but I don't name my layers, and this is because I name my layers after I'm done designing. I will select a group of items I like to name, group them and give it a name, so it makes my re-edit or review to be very easy. So you can name your layers when designing or name your layers after you are done designing it, all based on your choice. I don't see it as a personal rule or as a rule that I must name my layers when designing. If you know what you are doing, then you are good to go. After all, professional says break the rules if you know them. Okay, that's fine. Let's continue. So I'm going to click on the layer where I have the ellipse one, copy, press Ctrl T to adjust that, and you can reduce this again. Hold Alt to reduce this at the center just like this. Going to reduce it this way and you have something that looks like this. So you leave it there and hit on OK. So we have one bigger circle just like this, and we have one smaller circle just like that. We have a bigger circle and a smaller circle in the two layers like this. Then I'm going to click on the first ellipse, that's the first circle, and click on U to edit this. You click on where you have the shapes editing panel, just like what you see here. You're going to click on the fill and you click on the gradient fill to activate the gradient like this. I'm going to click on the face slider here and type in this hex code, okay? D54301. So that's the code. You click on OK and you double click on this other slider and type in this hex code. And why I'm giving you this hex code, so you can be on the same page with me. So you click on FC8C00. So you have this exact same hex code, and this was how it was gotten from this other crossover and takeover colors. So it matches each other just like what you seen here. And once you are done with that, you can deactivate everything. So you have this done just like this. It really looks very cool and very nice. So next thing we are going to do is to click on the tool where we have the shapes again and click on the rectangle tool, and we are going to create a shape just like this. And once you do that, you can see I have these options where I can make my shapes to have some curves. So I'm going to hold on these curves and make it have some round edges like this. You can make your shape have this same round edges just like this, and press Ctrl right square bracket to bring this to the top. So you see the shape takes the very same color we had for the circle. See, it takes the same gradient, and we're going to bring this to the top right here. But if your shape does not take the same gradient, you can still do the same process again, or you copy the layer style and paste it on this one to get the very same gradient on this shape. So next thing you are going to do is to go to edit, and you go to transform, and you go to warp. And when you go to warp, you go to custom here where you have the warp here. You click on arc and then you can adjust your arc the way you want it to be. You click on the bend here and adjust the bend, and you know, when you bring it down, just like what you see here, bring it down around 20 30 looks perfect. Okay, I'm going to leave it at 30 and place it just right here. This looks very cool and very, very nice. Okay, fine. So I'm going to activate my text tool and type here theme, just like this. And you're going to click on theme and bring it just around here. Press Ctrl T to transform, adjust the size just like this and place it around here. This looks cool and very nice. Then you click on enter to place this on the design once you're done with that. But you see, it's not aligning with the curve. Okay, I'm going to click on my text to select that, change my font to Montserrat. Okay, Montserrat bold looks perfect for this. So I'm going to click on type, click on warp text, and the same thing we did again, none, click on arc, and then adjust your bend, something like that, plus 15 looks perfect. So I'm going to place it around here. Fine and very, very fine. Then I'm going to copy this just into here. I will not, and blah blah blah, copy it and bring it to Photoshop and press T on your keyboard to activate your text tool and paste this again. Press Ctrl A to highlight all and change your color to black. Yeah, this is going to be black. And change your font to Champion here. And I'm going to leave it at Champion Gothic Middle Width. I think this looks perfect. Then I'm going to place it around here. And I'm going to break my text just like this. I will not end the way they plan. Press Ctrl A. Click on where you have the character. Adjust your leading to auto, just like this. Then you can adjust your leading again and make it come closer a little. This looks perfect. So you press Ctrl T, and remember, everything is aligned to the left at this point. So I'm going to adjust this way and place it here, just like this. This looks cool and very nice. Then I'm going to use the remaining space I have to place every other detail I have for this flyer. And next thing I want to do is to bring in the date and time. So I'm going to bring in the date where we have Wednesday and so on. I'm going to bring in Wednesday 29th first. Copy that, bring it to Photoshop and activate your text tool and paste. So I have Wednesday 29th just here. You can break this text like this. Select or change the font to Montserrat again, and make sure you have Montserrat bold just like this. Adjust the leading, make it come closer just like that. So this looks very cool and very nice. You can adjust the scale again like this, and that looks cool. So I'm going to press Ctrl J to duplicate this and bring this to this other side of the design, place it there. And then we're going to change this to Friday, just like that. Friday 31st. It looks very cool and very nice. So I'm going to leave it just the way it is. And then you click on your shapes again, click on your triangle tool, click on Photoshop, and you have this create triangle. You click on OK to create this triangle. Then I'm going to rotate my triangle just like this and reduce it. Hold shift to get a nice reduction, and then reduce it again. This is just around there, so you have something that looks like this. Very cool and very, very nice. Then I'm going to select everything that is happening here, the Friday, the Wednesday, and the triangle, and press Ctrl G to group them. Then you can name this group date and time. So that makes me organize myself and place things on the same layer, just like that. Place it around here. This looks very cool and very nice. Don't worry, we're going to change the colors of this stuff when it's time. Then I'm going to bring in every other stuff I have here. December 2021. Copy that, bring it to Photoshop. Activate T on your keyboard and paste this. So you have December 2021. Bring it just way down here. Just like that. It looks very cool and very nice. Then you can activate the group again. Select the bold layers just like this. Take it upwards a little so you have space for every other stuff for this flyer. I'm going to copy out the 5 p.m. Delhi and bring it just way down here again. So we have this perfect. I'm going to adjust the tracking for this one, something around 500 on the tracking. Perfect. I'm going to place it just here. Now everything looks scattered, but I'm going to use some kind of shapes to organize this stuff. So I'm going to click on my shapes again, activate your rectangle tool and create this shape like this. And when you do that, you get this curve. So you're going to adjust these curves and give this shape some curves like this. And I'm going to click on my fill and click on no fill. I don't want fill for this. Click on your stroke and give it a kind of stroke that has a red color. So I'm going to activate my color and make my stroke to be red. Activate the red color and this looks cool. Activate your stroke pixel to 3. So I have 3 points for my stroke pixel just like this, but it looks as if the stroke pixel is too small. So I'm going to click on U again. When you click on U, you activate the shape which you select and then activate the stroke pixel again and make it 4 points. That looks perfect and very nice. So this is what we get. Then you're going to click on the shapes again and activate your ellipse. Create this ellipse like this. And this time I want to give it a fill. So you click on your stroke and click on no fill on the stroke. So I don't want a stroke. This time around I'm going to activate my fill and give it a red color. So my fill is now red color. You place this here. And this looks very... So you click on your triangle at the center here. Press U to activate the edit. Click on fill and give it the red color as well. So my triangle has this red color as well. And then you click on your text tool to activate. Activate that. Change your color of 29 to red. Change 31st also to red as well. Just like that. And that looks very perfect. So this is what we get. It looks so organized and it looks cool. So I'm going to bring in every of this stuff I did into the group where I created for date and time. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to activate all these layers that was created on the same page, select them all and press Ctrl left square bracket to bring them inside the group, just like what you see here. So everything is now inside the group. You see, if I deactivate, you see, if I hide the group, it hides everything because everything is now inside the group. So I'm going to press Ctrl T to activate that and reduce this again because it's actually too big. It's so big. And I'll place it there. It looks very cool and nice. Next thing I need is an icon for this. So I'm going to activate my folder again and bring in my date and time icon into Photoshop. So you can adjust the scale, reduce the scale like this and bring it just right here. Reduce the scale again. That looks very cool. You can place it around here. I'm going to change the color. So I'm going to press Ctrl left square bracket to take it inside the date and time group. But you see, it's not inside the date and time group. So I'm going to open up the drop down for date and time. Press Ctrl left square bracket to place it inside the group as well. So I have the icon inside the group as well. So you click on the icon layer, just like what you see here. You can name the layer icon so it makes it easy for you. That looks very cool. Next thing I'm going to do is to change my color overlay to white. So I'm going to change the color overlay to white just like that. And it activates that. Did you see what I just did? Okay, let me do it again so you see what I did. Click on your blending options. Click on color overlay and you click on white. Okay, so this is what we get. It looks very cool and very nice. So it just left with few steps for us to be done with this flyer design. So I'm going to open up my Microsoft again and copy our Ministering Anointed Men of God. Copy this out and bring it to Photoshop. Press T to activate the text tool and paste this just right here. And then you're going to change the colors to white. So you click and select all by pressing Ctrl A and then you take this to white and make sure your text is white. Then I'm going to align this text to the right. So you make sure it's at right alignment, and then you can place it just around here. Press Ctrl T and scale this up just like this, so it will be seen very clearly. I'm going to hit on T on my keyboard, select ministry, click on the color, and bring your eyedrop tool to where you have this color, because I need to use this exact same color. You can see the color, you can see the hex code just right here. Click on OK. So that's the color I have for ministering anointed men of God. Then I want this to be on a separate layer and not inside the date and time. So I'm going to press Ctrl right square bracket to take this to the top, so it is on a separate layer on its own. Then I'm going to open up my Microsoft once again and copy out Friday 31st blah 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 till you reach where you have the time, and copy that and bring it to Photoshop as well and paste this right here. Ctrl A to select all, change the typeface to Gotham. Now I want to make this so large because it's actually my center of focus as well, so I'm going to place it just at the same side here and adjust this just like that. And I'm going to break this text because it's so long. Highlight night and increase the font size for night and leave it around here. That looks perfect. Click on your character, adjust your leading again so you have something just like this. It looks cool. Select time and reduce the font size for time, something around that. Looks very cool and very nice. So you can leave it just at this point, you can adjust this again so you have this done. You know, this flyer is actually handling different purpose, so I'm going to do this just to make sure all its purpose is done. Highlight crossover night, change the color to the same color we had done here again. Click on this to activate this same color where we have the orange, and this looks very cool and very nice. Wow, we are actually getting to the end of this flyer design. So I'm going to copy the church auditorium, select that, bring it to Photoshop, and activate your text tool and paste it just right here. Press Ctrl A, change the color to white just like that, and it looks very cool and nice. Hit on OK. Press Ctrl T and scale it up just like this, so we get something close to this. Fine. Then I'm going to bring in my icon which I have here, bring it to Photoshop, and then reduce this. It's actually black, so you won't see it. So for that, I'm going to select that, and then you click on your add layer style, and you have your color overlay. So I'm going to click on the color here, and using my eyedrop tool, you click on the orange color. So I want that to be orange color as well. You can bring it to this aspect, reduce this again, fine, and place it just around here, and we are done with this. So this is the final look of the flyer. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you have not subscribed to our channel yet, kindly do that. Subscribe and click on the bell so you get notified when I upload a new tutorial just like this one. And if you love this video, make sure you share this video with a friend and leave a like on the video. Thank you so much, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.